In this experiment, you will determine the heat of formation or the reaction enthalpies of magnesium oxide using a calorimetry method. Over the course of a reaction, energy may be either released or absorbed by a system. If a reaction at constant pressure releases heat, it is called exothermic process. This means that the sum of the enthalpy's products is less than that of the reactants, and the change in enthalpy for the reaction, or delta H, is negative. If a system absorbs heat from its surroundings as the reaction occurs, the sum of the enthalpies of the products is greater than the sum of the enthalpies of the reactants, and the change in the enthalpy is positive. This is known as an endothermic process. The magnitude of an enthalpy change depends on various factors. The calculation of an enthalpy of formation for the reaction that was shown on the previous slide is defined as producing 1 mole of products. Therefore, units of enthalpy change are kilojoules per mole. The enthalpy change for a reverse process is the same magnitude as the enthalpy for the forward process, however, it is of the opposite sign. This is shown on the slide by the reaction of hydrogen and iodine gas to produce hydrogen iodide. However, different phases of products or reactants can lead to different enthalpy values. The enthalpy of formation of liquid water is not the same as that of water vapor. So the enthalpy change for the reactant to produce water in different phases are not the same if you think about the reaction enthalpy as the sum of product minus reactant enthalpies. This is why enthalpy changes are usually defined as being at a given set of conditions called standard state. Standard state is defined as being at a temperature of 298.15 degrees Kelvin and a pressure of 1 bar or 1 atmosphere. The reaction you are looking at in this experiment is the combination of solid magnesium with oxygen gas to form solid magnesium oxide. We are lacking the equipment to directly measure the enthalpy change of this process, so an indirect method will be used. Enthalpy is a state function, so it is independent of the steps used to get from reactants to products as long as they begin and end in standard state conditions. This allows us to use a series of reactions to find the overall enthalpy change and formation of magnesium oxide. Combining the three reactions shown on the slides will give us the overall reaction we want to look at. This will be shown on the next slide. By reversing the reaction that is performed in part B and adding the formation of water from hydrogen and oxygen gases in the lab manual gives us the overall reaction we are looking for. According to Hess's law, the separate reaction enthalpies changes can be summed to get the enthalpy of the overall reaction. Now, because part B reaction is being reversed, the sign of the enthalpy change is being reversed. To sum up what we have learned so far, we know that the standard heat of formation for a reaction is when 1 mole of products is formed from elements in their standard state. We know that the standard state is defined as being at a temperature of 298.15 Kelvin and a pressure of 1 bar, which is approximately the same as 1 atmosphere. Finally, we know that the enthalpy changes for different reaction of being compared, the temperature, pressure, and physical state need to be specified. For this, variations from standard state during the lab or small differences in temperature and pressure will be assumed to be negligible and will be ignored when the experiment is performed. A simple calorimeter will be used to contain the reaction that is happening in this experiment. Calorimeters are generally insulated containers that trap heat that would otherwise be released to their surroundings. This one consists of a styrofoam cup containing a magnetic stir bar and thermometer. It will allow you to measure the temperature as the reaction proceeds, which you will use to determine the enthalpy change. The heat involved in the reaction will cause the temperature of the system to rise. The heat gap will be absorbed by the solution containing the reaction and the calorimeter. This quantity of heat absorbed will be equal in magnitude to the heat released, but opposite in sign. A second factor known as heat capacity is also important when calculating the enthalpy change for this reaction. The heat capacity of a body is defined as the amount of heat needed to raise its temperature by 1 degree. Knowing the temperature change of the reaction in part A and B, the heat capacity of your solution, and the calorimeter will allow you to calculate the change in enthalpy. The solution has a specific heat capacity of 3.49 joules per gram Kelvin, which must be multiplied by the mass of your solution. This will be found during the experimental procedure. The heat capacity of the calorimeter is simply 21 joules per Kelvin and includes the thermometer and magnetic stir bar. Because you know the heat capacities of the solution and the calorimeter, which were given on the previous slide and in the lab manual, and the temperature change during the reaction, finding the products gives you the magnitude of heat involved in the reaction with opposing signs. Changing the sign gives us the heat produced by the reaction. Enthalpy change is the heat divided by the number of moles of reactant or product you use performing the experiments, which count from the masses of magnesium. The calorimeters used in this experiment will lose a certain amount of heat to their surroundings, so the temperature after the addition of magnesium has to be found by extrapolating the graph of temperatures versus time. This is done as shown by drawing a straight line from where the temperature decreases to a vertical line made at the 5-minute mark. Reading straight to the y-axis from this point gives you T2, the final temperature of the system, which you can use to find the change in temperature caused by the reaction.